Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Google Ads API Developer Series on Working with REST. I'm Laura Chevalier, and I'm a Developer Relations Engineer on the Google Ads API. In this episode, we'll look at how to use the resource-specific mutate method over REST. If you'd like to follow along with the demo, make sure you have your Google Ads API credentials ready to authenticate. Oh, and if you find this video helpful, make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to be notified about future videos. Before we get to the demo, let's do a quick overview. Mutates in the Google Ads API are sent as post requests, and in general, they can create, update, or remove an entity in your ads account. The mutate method is not available for all resources, for example, any constant resource, like geotarget constants, or on resources that have special mutate functionality, like the customer client resource, which has a create customer client method, but no mutate method. In addition, not all resources allow for creation, updating, and removal. They might only allow creation and updating, for example. The REST interface documentation can help you establish whether a resource has a mutate method and what the mutate operation includes for that resource. For our demo, we're going to use the mutate method on the campaign resource. As we learned in the introduction episode of this series, a REST URL is comprised of the API version prefix, the resource name, and the method. In this case, we'll use V10. For mutates, we omit the trailing resource ID from the resource name. So the next part of the URL is customers/the customer ID/campaigns. And finally, we append the method with a colon. Now we put it all together for the full URL. You can also easily find the URL in the REST reference documentation. I've included an example of this in the video description. With the REST URL established and saved as an environment variable, let's create our campaign. For ease, I'll create a JSON file, which I'll pass as data to my curl request. With the mutate method, we send a JSON object containing an operations array, which in turn can contain multiple campaign operation objects. For instance, we could include multiple create operations in a single request if we wanted to create multiple campaigns at once, or a mix of create, update, and remove operations. For this example, we'll just create one campaign. So in our JSON file, we'll create a base object, and in that object, an operations array. In that array, each operation is represented as an object, and the type of operation is the key, so create in this case. And the value is another object containing the data we need for the campaign creation operation. We can go back to the reference documentation to see what all of the fields are and what the possible values are for each field. Depending on your use case, you might want to include any number of these fields. For our demo, I'll just include the required fields and the status field, which I'll set to paused or else it defaults to enabled. So we set the name, and I'll call this example campaign. Status we'll set to paused. Advertising channel type I'll set to search. Campaign budget should be the resource name of a budget in your account. I'm going to use one that I created in advance. And then campaign bidding strategy is a union field, so we select one bidding strategy for this. In this case, I'll do target spend, which is the equivalent of maximize clicks in the UI and can be left empty because it has no required fields. A quick tip here, if you want to verify that your JSON includes all of the required fields and that they're correctly written, you can set validate only to true to validate the request without executing it. So that would look like validate only, true. Have a look at the REST reference documentation for some other top-level fields that you might find useful, like partial failure and response content type. For the sake of the demo, we'll go ahead and save our JSON file without that. And now we can send a curl request. So that's curl. I'll pass my access token. the developer token. The login customer ID, which is our manager account. The content type. Then we pass in our JSON file as data. This is a post request, and we're posting to the REST URL that we determined earlier. So we run this, and I got a duplicate campaign name error. So it looks like I'm gonna have to go back and modify the campaign name that I gave to make it unique. We'll call this better example campaign. And now if we rerun that, we get the resource name of the campaign that we just created. Now that we've created our campaign, we can try out another campaign operation, the update operation. So similar to our create operation, we'll create a file called updateCampaign.json. For updates, we have two fields at the top level of our operation objects. Update mask, which specifies the names of the fields that we're updating, and update, which specifies a campaign object, just like for the create operation. Only this one must include the resource name of an existing campaign, and it doesn't need to include all of the required fields since they were already set by the creation operation. The update mask makes it so that we can send only the fields that we want to update in a request. Or if we already have the full object, we can send the whole thing instead of pulling out the fields that we want to update. So let's create our operations array. And this array contains update operations, each of which includes an update mask and a partial or full campaign object. In this case, we want to update the name and the status. So we set update mask to name, comma, status. Then update needs to contain the resource name, which I can get from the output of my previous request. The new name, we'll call this updated better example campaign. And the new status, which we will set to enabled. We could set other fields, but they would be ignored because we didn't specify them in our update mask. So now I'll save this and send it as a new request. So we'll just update our previous curl request to send the update campaign JSON file instead of the create file. And voila, it succeeded. So we've seen how to create and update a campaign through the REST API. Now let's see how to remove a campaign. I'll create a remove campaign JSON file like I did for the other two requests. As you might have guessed, instead of a create or an update field, here we need a remove field. So we'll again create our base object with an operations array. And this will have one remove operation. And the value of that remove operation is just the resource name of the campaign that we want to remove. I'll use the same campaign that we've been using for the rest of the demo. So I will save that, update my curl request to reference the remove campaign file, and we'll run that. And it worked. In the interest of time, we didn't do any reporting on our campaigns in this video. But you can check out our video on Search and Search Stream for more information on how you would do that. All right, that concludes our resource-specific Mutate demo. I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for joining.